Hi guys, this is Sam Skilz. We're here in HQ of SkillsDG Academy in Luxembourg. Today, I want to show and introduce you a RekordBox 7. But be careful, this video is going to be for the very beginners. If you already have a previous experience with RekordBox, this is definitely not for you. I'm going to break down this simple thing for the very beginners, how to download and how to make a playlist and to export it into a USB key. We're not going into deep functionalities, we're not going into the streaming part, but it's just keep it simple. I wanna break down this video under 10 minutes to make it simple for those who are just getting started. So if you are interested, bear with me and check this out, RekordBox 7. Follow up. So this is how we're gonna break down the video. First, you need a USB key. 16 gigabytes, it's enough. I mean, you can put hundreds of tracks, MP3 tracks into this type of USB key. 16 gigabytes, that's enough. If you have more, that's also very good. Now, you're supposed to have a music in your library, in your computer. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna create a new playlist and we're gonna drag and drop your music from your hard drive into the playlist under RekordBox. And the final step is to export that new playlist from your RekordBox into the USB key. That's it. It's very simple. We're not gonna complicate stuff. So let's go straight forward into the stuff. So first, what we're gonna do is to go to RekordBox.com. And the website is easy. You just look for download for free and you click on it. You have this window. You just agree to, it doesn't matter what it is. Anyway, you don't have a choice. And you click download. Automatically, the file is gonna be under your download folder. But in the meantime, they come and they suggest different plans and pricing from RekordBox. What you need to keep in mind, all these plans are mostly made for laptop users. If you are doing a USB key, it means that you are only gonna play under with the, you know, XDJ controller or a CDJs. But if you're not playing with your laptop, you don't need any of these plans. You just keep the free plan. It's working enough. You can export and you can even perform with it with limited things, but you can still perform quite good. But you cannot save on the cloud. You cannot do this professional stuff like optional on a Google Drive or on Dropbox. These things, maybe we can see the details about these plans another time. But the next thing, what you're gonna do is to come and create a profile. You gotta just put your name, address, so just say, don't you have an account, register an account. It's coming. So here you put your name, email address. I like RekordBox, they don't spam about any stuff. They will just keep you updated with the new versions. Keep in mind that the new versions coming up almost every couple of weeks. So keep it up to date, your software. You just need to re-download it and reinstall it and that's it, it's very fast. So it's very important that you create your profile here. They're gonna send you an email to confirm the email, of course, and then what you're gonna do, you come into your hard drive and you start the installation. You choose your language. We're gonna go for English here, but of course you have different languages. I'm gonna click yes, I agree. You know, you just agree to everything. This is the latest version of today. Actually, I already have it, but I'm just doing it for you to see exactly how it works. It will take a couple of minutes, but as you can see here, now is Alpha Theta. This is the new branding name from Pioneer DJ. They don't call themselves Pioneer DJ anymore. So if you see Alpha Theta,
is the new branding name from the company. Okay, so let's say it's run and finish. Yeah, going up, RekordBox. Of course, it will come with some playlists that I have already created. So this is just information stuff. It's gonna ask me, you see here, I already put my name and my address to activate the app. So first of all, if you install it for the first time, it's gonna ask you to put your data. I mean, I click here and I can go here to my plan. You can see that I have just have a free plan. I don't have anything special. You're only gonna put your email address and your password, and that's it. If you have a plan, if you wanna subscribe to plan, later on you can do it, then you will have other functionalities, including the cloud. So you can save your playlists on the cloud, and in case if you lose your laptop or if you have any problem, and you can save and synchronize playlists with three different computers, including your phone. Now, this part is important. As you can see here on the top left corner, it shows we are in performance mode. If I click in it, I have different modes. Lighting, you can, you know, control your lights. You can also edit tracks. But this is the part that is interesting for us today, the export mode. Make sure to select it, and things will change over here. Now, as you can see, we are in export mode. Export mode is to create playlists and export it into your USB key. Now I have two players. Either you can choose the view, two players, or one player. I'm gonna keep it as two players. And in this bottom here, you can see your playlists. This is the place where I can come into my collection. If I click on collection, all, it will show me all the tracks that I have on my library and on the library of the RekordBox. So 2003, you don't need that much, trust me. But anyway, and here, this genre and artists and album, they will be unlocked when you use the paid version. But today we don't need any of these. What we need is this part here. So when I click this part, I have all my playlists. This is a folder, you know, this is the folder for the school. So we have different genres. You have Afro, Afrobeat, you know, all this stuff that so people can play the music they want. But then all these are different playlists are put into one folder. So when if I close the folder, I have my sorting stuff. It's very clean. So what we need now is this part. So I can come and click on playlist. I can make plus here, and I will call it test playlist. Let's say like this. I push enter. Now I can see my playlist here is completely empty. What I will do, I will go into my hard drive, and I will just select some music from one of the folders. I have here Afro House, because this is what I'm playing lately, Afro House, Progressive, and Melodic House. I have many tracks here, so either I can select one by one, I just select one, and I drag and drop it here. And you can see it's analyzing the track from 0% to 100. When it comes to 100%, it means your track is completely analyzed. What does it mean analyzed? It's gonna use the name, the artwork, artist, the album, the key. I mean, it would get all the information that it needs as tag IDs. If you want to select more, you just select more with shift. And I can drag and I can drop them all over here. So you will see it will take a few seconds to a minute to analyze all the tracks. Normally, for the first time when you're gonna use this, as there is a small window gonna pop up to ask you, are you gonna analyze the key and the genre and also the phrases? You just click all of them, make sure that they're all selected and say yes. then it will get you all the information from each track that you are dropping here. Now, I can select one of the tracks. If I drag and drop it into the player, here I have the whole format and I can see the all, you know, the name. And this is our one of our latest track with Miss Mad, so probably gonna listen to this. You just click anywhere you want to listen. And that's it. So now when I have different tracks, I can, for example, I want to put this Mirage as the first one. I want to put this Vacant as the second one. You know, you just click, drag and drop, and that's it. When it's finished, make sure that you plug in your USB key into the computer or your laptop. And I can, if I click here, display devices, this icon here, I can see my device is on here. This is my USB key. So basically, if I come here to my playlist, display playlist, I just click right on my mouse and I have this sub menu open up, says export playlist here. I can just click on the name of the playlist, the USB key, and then it comes. It tells me, okay, this equipment, you can say it, don't ask me again anymore, but you know, just for information, this is the latest XDJ controllers from Pioneer, or Alpha Theta, the AZ and Opus and Omnius Duo. Just, this is just informative. So you can say, no, I don't want this anymore. Say, okay, and basically, you're done. You see here, it's exporting. You gotta wait until it finishes. It will take a couple of seconds. And then I can come here and I can see here my USB key. And when it's finished, I need to eject my USB key before that I plug out from the laptop or the computer. You can see it's finished, and when it's finished, it allows you to eject your USB key. Click eject, and that's it. So now you can take it from your computer and it's ready.
And here we go, we have it ready. This is very easy. You just plug it into your XDJ or your CDJ, go to your playlist, and you will find your new playlist that we have created. It takes a few minutes to export, don't expect hours. If it takes more than a few minutes, it means you have a problem with USB key. So probably you need to format the USB key before you use it. I hope this video was very easy to read, but I cannot make it more simple. This is the simplest way I can do this video. Now, if you have comments, please share, let me know your thoughts. If it helps, if it doesn't help, doesn't matter, you tell me. And I will make another one to go into deep functionalities of RekordBox. Thank you for watching, and I see you next time. Cheers.